Good morning again. This session is expected to deal with the issue of WMD Free Zone Conference in 2012. My main mission as the chairman of this session is to make sure that we shall this session will come to its peaceful end by 1 o'clock. I hope we shall manage to to do it. And as we all know, the 2010 NPT review conference agreed at the time on a final document which included a proposal to convene the conference in 2012 in aiming at establishing a Middle East free zone of WMD, including nuclear weapons and other kinds of non-conventional weapons, including delivery systems. And I should suggest several questions that we perhaps can focus on. Before that, I want to introduce the three speakers, which decided to speak from the seats. It's convenient, of course. The first speaker will be Mr. Camille Legrand. Camille is the director of the Fondation pour les Recherches Stratégiques in Paris, the leading think tank in France on strategic and security affairs. He's the director since the year of 2008. Before that, he held senior positions in the Ministry of Foreign Affairs and Defense in France, and has written extensively on European security, non-proliferation, and nuclear policy. Second speaker will be Ambassador Shimon Stein from INSS. Shimon, before he came to the INSS, has a long experience as a diplomat in the Israeli Ministry of Foreign Affairs. Among his positions, he was a deputy director for some years for CIS, Eastern and Central Europe, and also he was ambassador to Germany. Shimon has also wide experience in arms control, in disarmament and proliferation issues. And the last speaker will be Professor Gunay, who said ladies first. She's going to be the last one in this case. Professor Gunay is professor of international politics at Yildiz Technical University in Istanbul. She writes extensively on security issues, Western strategies, current international developments, foreign and security policy of the United States, of the EU and of NATO and Turkey, and arms control and armament. So these are the three speakers. Before we start, I want to raise several questions that perhaps members of this panel would like to refer to. First of all, what should be the concept, the leading concept of the conference? What should be the agenda of such a conference? Because to a large extent, the definition of the concept and of the agenda will dictate to a large extent the failure or the success of such a conference. Secondly, who should come to the conference? The mandate speaks about all the Middle East countries. But will Israel decide to come? Will Iran decide to come? What might be their conditions for the participation in this conference? Is it possible to meet their demands towards such a conference? Third, what is the chance that this conference will succeed? What will be regarded as a success? What are the conditions which might lead to a success? What can be done? What can we learn from the past failure in this regard? First question is, the conference should deal with all kinds of WMD. Is it possible? Is it not going to complicate the whole discussions of the conference and lead them to some kind of a deadlock? Can one divide between the dealing with WMDs and the conventional balance of power in the Middle East? And since the conference is supposed to deal also with missiles, what about the huge arsenal of rockets and missiles of Hezbollah, of Hamas, which are not going to be invited to this conference? Another question is, how should this conference refer to the concerns and interests of the main actors in the Middle East? Because without referring to these concerns, it will be difficult to make any progress. The sixth question will be, what is the linkage between the agenda of this conference and the Iranian nuclear issue, which we spoke about this morning? Will the conference try to deal with the Iranian nuclear program of Israel too, as other Arab countries might demand? Another question is, assuming that the success of the conference will depend on the position of the regional powers, what will be the contribution of the external powers in such a conference, the superpowers? And finally, last question, facing all these difficulties, is it possible that the conference will convene in 2012? So more so since the Middle East countries are preoccupied today with other business like the regional upheaval. So these are some of the questions that perhaps some of the speakers would like to speak about, and I would like to invite Camille Grand to start, please.